In this video, we're going to finish out the angles and quadrilaterals worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. There will be a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now in this next section, we're going to be solving for x. Remember, the angles within a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. So that means that angle F plus angle E plus angle G plus angle D equal 360 degrees. Angle F we know is 86. Angle E is 94, angle G is also 94, and angle D is 11x minus 2. That is all equal to 360. Now we're going to combine like terms, 86, 94, 94, and 2. So we'll have 86 plus 94 plus 94, that equals 274, and we're subtracting 2 to get 272. So 272 plus 11x equals 360. So when we subtract 272 from both sides, we'll get 11x, the term with the x, all by itself. 360 minus 272 is 88. So 11x equals 88. Now I just have to divide by 11 to isolate the x, or in other words, get the x all by itself. So 88 divided by 11 is 8. So x equals 8. In number 9. So that means that if I was to take that value of x and plug it in for x within the equation for angle D, then I would get the measure of angle D. However, we're just solving for x, so x is 8. In number 10, m plus j plus l plus k equals 360. M is 17x plus 8. J is 66, L is 74, and K is 110. That is all equal to 360. Again, I'm combining my like terms, 8, 66, 74, and 110. So I'll have 17x plus the like terms added together equals 258. So 17x plus 258 equals 360. So I'll subtract 258 as my next step. That'll give me that 17x is equal to 102. And finally, when I divide by 17, I'll get that x is equal to 6. So 6 is my solution in number 10. In 11, both N and L are right angles and therefore are 90 degrees. So all the angles added together will equal 360. So I have 90 degrees for N, plus 98 for M, plus 90 for L, plus 17x minus 3. That is equal to 360. So now I'm going to combine my like terms. 90 plus 98 plus 90 equals 278, and when we subtract 3 from that, we get 275. So 275 plus 17x equals 360. Subtracting 275 from both sides, I'll get that 17x, that's all that's left on my left-hand side of my equation, is equal to 360 minus 275, which is 85. Then I'll divide both sides by 17 to get that x is equal to 5. So 5 is my solution in number 11. In number 12, I have 90 and 90 for R and Q, so 90 plus 90 plus 16x minus 6 plus 15x equals 360. Combining my like terms, I'm going to combine 90, 90, and negative 6. I'm also going to combine 16x and 15x. So 90 plus 90 equals 180, and when I subtract 6 from that, I get 174. So I'll have 174 plus 16x plus 15x equals 31x, and that is equal to 360. Subtracting 174 from both sides, I'll get that 31x equals 186. Dividing both sides by 31, I'll get that x is equal to 6. So 6 is my solution in number 12. X is equal to 6. In number 13, I have 76 plus 104 plus 104 plus 25x plus 1 equals 360. 76 plus 104 plus 104 plus 1 equals 285. 285 plus 25x equals 360. Subtracting 285 from both sides will give me that 25x equals 75. And when I divide both sides by 25, 75 divided by 25 is 3. So x equals 3 in number 13. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 14. 104 plus 104 plus 76 equals 284. So V plus U plus T equals 284 degrees. So 360 degrees is the sum of all the angles in the quadrilateral. If I subtract the sum of three of those angles, which is 284, that's going to equal my last angle W, which is 10x minus 4. So 360 minus 284 equals 76. So 76 equals 10x minus 4. I'm going to add 4 to both sides to get that 80 is equal to 10x. When I divide by 10, I'll get that 8 is equal to x. So 8 is my solution. Now remember, if I wanted to solve for this angle W, I would take that value of x, which is 8, and plug it in to x in the equation. So now when we solve for x, we're going to be finding the measure of the indicated angle. So number 15, we're solving for x and plugging that back in for the x in the measure of angle y, since we're solving for the measure of angle y. So we know that the measure of angle y equals 2x plus 118. However, all these angles added up equal 360. So W, which is 90, plus x, which is 84, plus y, which is 2x plus 118, plus z, which is 2x plus 68, equals 360. Combining like terms, 2x plus 2x is 4x, and 4x will get added to 360. So 360 plus 4x equals 360. So when I subtract 360 from both sides, I'll get that 4x equals 0. And when I divide by 4, I'll get that x equals 0. So I'm going to take this value of x, which is 0, and plug it in for my x in my measure of angle y. So I get that 2x is now 2 times 0 plus 118, which 2 times 0 is 0. So the measure of angle y equals 118 degrees. So 118 degrees is my solution for the measure of angle y. In 16, I'm solving for the measure of angle F. We have here indicated that F is equal to 10x. So we're going to solve for x and plug that back in. D is 82 degrees plus E, which is 105, plus F, which is 10x, plus G, which is 8x plus 11. That is all equal to 360. Combining my like terms, 10x plus 8x is 18x, and that will get added to 198, which is equal to 360. So subtracting 198, I'll get that 18x equals 162. So when I divide by 18, I'll get that x is equal to 9. So I'm going to take that value of 9 and plug that in for my x in the measure of angle F. So F is equal to 10 times x, which is 10 times 9. So the measure of angle F equals 90 degrees. Number 17, I'm solving for the measure of angle M, which is equal to 10x minus 5. So I'm solving for x and plugging that back in. 10x minus 5 plus 8x plus 13 plus 95 plus 95 all equals 360. Combining like terms, I'll get that 18x plus 198 equals 360. Subtracting 198 from both sides I'll get that 18x equals 162. Dividing by 18, I'll get that x is equal to 9. So now I'm going to take that value of 9 and plug it in for x in the measure of angle M. So 10 times 9 minus 5 equals 90 minus 5, which is equal to 85 degrees. So the measure of angle M equals 85 degrees. And lastly in this worksheet, number 18. However, before I go over the answer to this, please remember to click that subscribe button. All subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, for number 18, we're solving for the measure of angle M, which is equal to 11x minus 2. 11x minus 2 plus 14x minus 7 plus 93 plus 76 equals 360. Combining my like terms, 11x plus 14x is going to give me 25x. And that's going to be added to negative 2 plus negative 7, which is negative 9, plus 93, which is 84, plus 76, which is 160. And when 25x is added to 160, that's going to equal 360. So subtracting by 160 from both sides, I'll get that 25x is equal to 360 minus 160, which is 200. So when I divide both sides by 25, I'll get that x is equal to 8. Now I'm just going to take that value of 8 and plug it in for x in the equation for the measure of angle M. So 11 times x, or 11 times 8, minus 2. That's going to be 88 minus 2, which equals 86. Degrees. So the measure of angle M is 86 degrees in number 18. And with that, we finish up the angles and quadrilaterals worksheet. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. And if you haven't already, subscribe and like this video.